The Supreme Court ruling the Commission on Elections committed grave abuse of discretion when it disqualified Smartmatic from bidding in the 2025 polls. Last year, the COMELEC disqualified Smartmatic from all its procurement activities due to issues that hounded the voting tech provider. These include allegations of bribery and alleged irregularities in the transmission and reception of the 2022 elections. Despite its decision, the High Court says this will not nullify the contract awarded to winning bidder South Korea's Miru Systems.
COMELEC committed grave abuse of discretion when it disqualified Smartmatic before it had submitted any bids, without any reference to the eligibility requirements prescribed by its Bids and Awards Committee. It held that COMELEC implemented a discretionary pre-qualification regime antithetical to the Government Procurement and Reform Act. However, despite the finding of grave abuse of discretion on the part of the COMELEC, the Supreme Court did not find it sufficient to nullify the public bidding or award of the contract. It cited considerations of equity, justice, practicality, and the doctrine of operative fact. This means that the law produced consequences before it was declared unconstitutional that cannot always be ignored or disregarded.
Smartmatic was the provider of the country's automated election system for over a decade before it was replaced by Miru Systems this year, the lone bidder of the nearly 18 billion peso contract.
The Supreme Court orders the Philippine Senate to comment on embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy's petition for a temporary restraining order against the upper chamber. The court, though, says the arrest order still stands as it is still in the process of deciding on Quiboloy's petition. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri approved an arrest order against Quiboloy on March 19 for his repeated snubbing of Senate hearings into allegations of sexual abuse. Quiboloy is seeking the Supreme Court's nullification of that arrest order.
The respondents in this case, they were required to file a comment within 10 days on the petition, as well as the prayer for the issuance of the TRO and the writ of preliminary injunction. So right now, it's at that stage. We are awaiting the comment of the respondents.
Senator Risa Ontiveros, for her part, says she's ready to face the High Court's order with her counsel, former Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. Ontiveros heads a Senate committee probing Quiboloy's allegedly abusive behavior.
It's time to face the music. That's a message of former Senate President Franklin Drulon to the fugitive pastor. We're now joined by the former senator. Senator Drulon, good afternoon. Thank you very much for talking to us.
Hi, good afternoon, and thank you for having me today.
It's nice to talk to you again, sir. But curious, what motivated you to issue a statement on this development, Supreme Court letting the Senate's arrest order for Quiboloy to stand for now?
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your question again.
I was just curious what motivated you to come out with to issue a statement on this development by the Supreme Court letting the Senate's arrest order in Quiboloy stand for now.
Well, even if I'm ready in the private sector, being a lawyer by profession and having been in the Senate and the Senate president for years, these are issues which would interest me from the point of view of a student of law, mm-hmm. and nothing else.
And asking you now, sir, as a lawyer, the Supreme Court, instead of ruling on Quiboloy's petition for that TRO outright, had asked the Senate for its comment on that petition. Could that in any way be interpreted as a sign that the petition still has a shot at being granted? Or if not, what could this move be for?
Let us remember that the Supreme Court had the power to restrain the Senate and the committee from continuing with the investigation in aid of legislation of Quiboloy. I repeat that. The Senate could have been stopped by the Supreme Court through a temporary restraining order prayed for by Quiboloy. The fact that the court refrained from using that power is an indication that it is their view that Kibuloy is not entitled to that immediate relief, without prejudice, of course, to finally deciding the case on its merits after the TROs are issued. But what is important is that the Senate and the committee can continue with its work as a committee investigating in age of legislation, which also means that the contempt order stands, and Kibuloy can be arrested by the Senate Sergeant at Arms on orders of the Senate President to face the committee in its hearings.
And you have asked Kibuloy to face the music already. However, Mr. Kibuloy refuses to surface. He even issued conditions for his appearance at the Senate and even to surrender to authorities. Is there any more that the Senate can do at this point to force Mr. Kibuloy to cooperate, to come out?
No, the Senate as an institution can call to task the Philippine National Police, ask for its assistance in order to enforce the contempt order and have Kibuloy in its custody. Let me just emphasize that the arrest order is not for a punishment in this particular case. Mm-hmm. It is only a remedy resorted to by the Senate in order to force Kibuloy to respond to questions. This is decided by a number of cases in the past in the Supreme Court. I would repeat, this is not an order to arrest as a matter of punishment, but as a means to enforce the Senate order to have Kibuloy testify. The moment he testifies, then the Senate arrest order is no longer enforceable. The problem of Mr. Kibuloy is that he has cases filed by the Department of Justice before the courts, and this the one particular case in Pasay City is non-bailable. So his problem is, if he surrenders to the Senate and he does not intend to respect the processes of the courts, then he will continue to be in hiding.
Right. Lastly, Mr. Senator, you've mentioned that already, authorities are still looking for him and they seem to be having a hard time in finding Mr. Kibuloy. Your thoughts on that, sir?
Well, you know, in general, not only the Senate contempt order, but more particularly the order, the warrant of arrest of the courts. Our system here is put to test. A lot of people say there are two systems of justice in our country, one for the rich and the powerful, another for the poor and the ordinary citizen. And as long as the arrest order of the courts particularly cannot be enforced because Kibuloy cannot be found and cannot be located, this is a slap on the executive branch, particularly the enforcement of orders, and this does not augur well for our people's confidence in our court system. Sasabihin nila, dalawang klase ng justisya sa atin, isa para sa mahirap, isa para sa mga mayayaman at makapangyarihan. Kaya, to your question, therefore, I say that the credibility of our justice system, the credibility of our ability to enforce valid orders of the government is on test.
Mr. Dulon, we appreciate your thoughts. Thank you very much for talking to us.
My pleasure.